Can I also switch off the camera and teach? How do you feel? I'll switch off the camera and I'll just teach. How do you feel? I feel the same thing. Like if you guys switch off the camera and do the session. Yeah, please switch on the camera and try the session.
A very good morning to all the participants. Welcome to day two of Faculty Development Program on Organizational Behavior Advanced, organized by Department of Business Management, Mahatma Gandhi University, Nalgonda. I am Aya Kalyani, research scholar from Department of Business Management, Mahatma Gandhi University. Today, session one is about yoga and meditation by Ms. Katyayini Reddy, IIT Madras. Session two is about Emotional Intelligence and Stress Management by Dr. Chetan Srivastava, Associate Professor, School of Management Studies, University of Hyderabad. Session three is about Dealing with Incivility in Organizations, again by Dr. Chetan Srivastava. So, before introducing today's first resource person, I request everybody to please switch on the videos so that ma'am can see you and give the instructions. Ms. Katyayini Reddy is a yoga instructor at IIT Madras since 2011. Her trainees include faculty, students, and other staff at IIT. She also is a yoga trainer at Shivananda Center, Tiruvannamayur, since 2008. Key instructor at 136.1 Yoga Studio and Monad Yoga Studio. She is experienced in designing and delivery of customized yoga programs, including those of therapy, pregnancy, kids, beginners, and open classes. She is a qualified yoga teacher under the scheme of voluntary certification of yoga professionals launched by Ministry of AYUSH in 2017. She has done teacher training course from Shivananda Yoga Center, Uttarkashi, India, 2007, which is a certified worldwide yoga alliance for 200-hour standard of registered yoga schools. She's also has done advanced teacher training course from Shivananda Yoga Vedanta Center, Madurai, India, 2008, which is certified by the worldwide yoga alliance for 500-hour standard for registered yoga schools. Her academic qualifications include BSc Science from Kakatiya University, Telangana, and MSc Yoga from Annamalai University, Tamil Nadu. She is fluent in English and Telugu languages. I once again welcome you, ma'am. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you for your introduction. So we'll start the session with one small prayer. Prayer actually brings a good energy, good vibes. So keep your hands comfortably. Place your palms above your knees. Close your eyes. Take a deep inhalation. Try to chant Om. Gajananam Bhutaganadisevitam Kapitta Jambo Falasara Bakshitam Bhumasutam Soka Vinasakaranam Namami Vigneshwara Pada Pankajam Om Namah Shivaya. Let's have an interaction session. Let me know what you are expecting from this session, so that I can do full justice for you. Like, okay, this 1.5 hours, what do you want to learn? What you are expecting? Just give me some suggestions so that I can focus on that. I can teach you that. Just quickly give me your this thing. Please. Hmm. Yeah.
Yes, yeah. Madam.
Yeah, tell me.
Sharad
you
here.
You tell me your name and then
yes.
Tell me.
Yes, I am myself Sharad from Vadodara, Gujarat.
Yeah, tell me, Sharad. Oh, hi.
Just I want some snacks types yoga so that 5 minutes or 10 minutes during working hour or between gap of two lectures.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes, it
is extended. Then, yeah. Then what else?
Good morning. My name is Ocean. I'm from Acham, Aurangabad.
Ocean. Tell me.
I just wanted to know, since sometimes we keep sitting for long hours and then we get sprain on our back and this. So any yoga or any asana for that purpose, so that we can do it in between, as Mr. Sharad said, a very quick time yoga asana.
Okay, sure. Then what else you're expecting? Quickly give some, your this thing, doubts, like what you're expecting, so that I'll focus more on that. Yeah.
Ma'am, good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Khalid Parvez. I'm from Aurangabad. IHM.
Hi, Khalid.
As well.
Yeah. Tell
me. Ma'am, I think most of us in our day-to-day routine, we are always having a lot of stress, a lot of work pressure with us. So is there a short-term mental cleanse kind of meditation that we can perform when the end of business hours happens?
Yeah.
So some guidance from you on that front as well.
Okay, sure.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Vipul here from Rabindranath Tagore University.
Hi, Vipul. Tell me.
Ma'am, I would like to ask you something like ki jaise hum focus karna chahte hain to ek proper nahi ho pata focus. Jaise ki kehte hain na ki meditate kariye to aapko ek peace, inner peace milta hai. But how to do that? How to get that peace? Jab aap itta और कॉन्स्टेंटली आपका जो ब्रेन है वो यू नो इट्स गोइंग इन द लूप कि हाँ यू आर थिंकिंग अ पर्टिकुलर थिंग एंड इट्स लाइक कि इट्स इन अ सर्कल इट्स इन अ साइकिल बट यू आर नॉट एबल टू फोकस तो हाउ टू यू नो गेट अ प्रॉपर फोकस पॉइंट कि जहाँ पे आप शांति से बैठ के अपने आप से बात कर सकें अपने आप के लिए बात कर सकें
Just quickly, I'll give you another 5 minutes. Let me know your expectations so that I want to do full justice for this session. Yeah. That's all right.
A small request, ma'am. I guess most of them are faculty and they are at their workplace because offline has already started. So if you can teach some exercises which you can sit on the chair and do.
So you want to do quick sitting in the office chair and all, right? So at least some of you, please switch on the camera so that I can watch you guys, what you're doing and all. Okay. So when you're sitting on the chair, always make sure you're keeping your spine straight. Okay. Most of your issues, like whether it is neck issue, back issue, like all the spine related issues are basically your sitting position. Most of the time you'll be sitting like this and you're typing with your system and all, right? So that you just check, keep checking your position. Always keep your spine straight, okay? If you want to keep your spine straight, what you can do, you can actually keep your feet on some height, okay? So that helps. Keep some small stool or some, you know, you get yoga bricks also in office and all. I'm not sure whether you can carry all those things. Keep some height, okay, some box or something you keep under the feet. So naturally that makes your spine straight. So this is the first thing you have to focus. Always keep checking your position. Once your spine is straight, what happens? Energy also moves systematically. When you sit like this, when you do your work, what happens? Your energy will get blocked. So this body is basically works on energy, right? So always check your position. That's the first thing you have to focus. Your spine should be straight when you're sitting in the chair. Okay. So simple movements. Okay, this physical body works like a machine, like any other automobile. This body also works like that. So every joint needs some movement every day. Okay, when we don't use them properly, that's when it starts giving you trouble. So every day, every joint needs some movement. Okay, so even in sitting position, before you start your work, you can do all these joint movements. Okay, first thing, you have to start with neck exercise. Okay, it hardly takes 2 minutes. Okay, suppose if you have cervical spondylitis, I'll tell you which movement to avoid. Otherwise, you start your work with neck exercise, because neck is very close to the brain. Okay, all the stress, whatever you go through in the mind, the first part which is going to be affected is the neck. Okay, to relax your neck, you have to do some neck exercises. So that helps you to increase your memory, that helps you to sharpen your intelligence. So that's how it helps. Let me show you first practically, then I'll make you to do. So there are only 3 exercises. It hardly takes 2 minutes. Each practice you have to do just 3 times. That's all. So close your eyes. So yoga means, like, the actual meaning of yoga is yuj. Okay, yuj means connection. So whole universe, you are just a small, particle in this whole universe. So your connection with the ultimate, whatever name you want to give, like whether it is God or energy, supreme energy, microcosm, whatever name you give, okay? Your connection, this small thing with the ultimate is yoga. Okay, it has a deep meaning. Okay, it's not simply touching your toes to the head. It's not like that. Why yogis did all these things, you know, they don't want to go through this disease, cycle of life and birth again and again and again. So why they discovered this? To connect with the ultimate, to get rid of this life and birth cycles. So that's the goal of yoga. For that spiritual inquiry, what they discovered, you need a very, very intelligent mind and a strong body. That's the reason why they did all this yoga, breathing practices and all. So forget about all those things. How to lead a stress-free life, okay? In day-to-day life, what all you have to do, how to lead a healthy life. Okay, how to prevent all those health issues. See, till 35, if you don't do any exercise, it's fine. Okay, because every day, like, you know, millions of cells are there. Once you cross 35, what happens? Every day, millions of cells start, like, you know, decaying. So the decaying process starts after 35. Okay, don't wait till 35, then you start doing some exercise. Okay, only when you are in 20s, start doing something, you know. You have to keep this body fit, okay, healthy, okay. So every day in 24 hours, you take 1 hour for yourself. The time for yourself is yoga, okay, where you're going to spend time with your body, with your breath, with your mind, and with your energies. So that me time, don't say that you're too busy. Once you can't take time for yourself, like what Swamiji, my guru, Swami Shivananda himself, he was a medical doctor. What he said, like, if you can't take time for yourself, there is no meaning for this life. Okay? So take time. Just don't say that you are too busy. Don't ever say that. Only when you take time for yourself, you get time for everything. Rest of the 23 hours goes very peacefully. So yoga is self-discipline. The meaning, actual meaning of yoga is self-discipline. Okay. So there is one guru generally, like a father of yoga is Patanjali. What he said, what is yoga? He gave one definition. Yoga chitta vritti nirodaha. How to stop this mental modifications. Okay, that is what is yoga. Yoga means to stop all these mental modifications and to see the bottom of the mind. Okay, that is what is yoga. For that, you have to work every day. Take little time for yourself. then you will understand what it is. So in your workplace, how to do this neck exercise, let me start. Okay, keep your palms on your thighs. First, press your chin down. Then slowly take the head back. Let me show you all the movements first. Chin down, take the head back. This is the first movement. Then the second movement, turn the head side to side. This is the second movement. Okay, third movement, bend your neck like this, side to side. Okay, then the third variation where you're going to rotate your neck clockwise like this, very slow. You have to be aware of your breathing and fix the mind on the neck. Clockwise, then slow, reverse. Just these four movements. It hardly takes 2 minutes. Wait, I'll give you the instruction. Wait. You're doing with me. Wait, relax. First thing, you keep your spine straight. Okay, close your eyes. Each exercise, you're doing three times. Press your chin down. You see before and after how it makes you very alert. Press your chin down. Slowly take the head back. Watch your breathing and head back. Head back. Then press your chin down. Chin down. Then slowly take the head back. Head back. Then press your chin down. Take the head back. Head back. Back to center. This is the first variation. Second one, just turn the neck. Chin should come above the shoulder. Back to center. Again, take to the left side. Back to center. Again, right side, center, left side, center, right, center, left side, center. That's all. Three times. Second variation is also over. Third one. Just bend your neck to the right side. Come up. Left side. You see, anybody with neck issues, like if you have cervical spondylitis, you do only this movement. That's better. Instead of taking the head up and down, you can do turn head side to side and do only this. Bend your neck. You can feel the stretch on the opposite side. Come up, then right side. Slowly come up, left side. Close your eyes. Fix your mind on the neck. You're doing every practice with awareness. Don't do mechanically. You just have to connect with the stretch. Observe your breathing. One more time. To the right, up, and left. Then back to center. Last movement. Press your chin down. Press your chin down. Take your right ear on the right shoulder. Head back. Head back. Left. Left. Down. Right. Back. Left. Down. Again. Right. Back. Left. Down, right, back, left, down. Now start from left, slow, very slow. Back, right, down, left, back, right, down. Last time, left, back, right, down. Back to center. Now close your eyes. Observe the neck. How it feels now. Just few seconds. Give that time. Now tell me, how do you feel after neck exercise? Khalid, Vipul. How do you feel?
Feeling good.
Feeling good. It is relaxed now.
Relaxed.
So it hardly takes 2 minutes. Okay. So start your day when you're sitting with your system with this neck exercise. Must practice if you want to increase your memory. Okay. If you want to achieve your goal, this is the best practice. Neck exercise, because all the energy system, it will start from shoulder blades, it moves to the neck and then to the brain. So neck exercise is must. So 2 minutes, you must spend time with this neck exercise. Okay, then you will come to the eyes, because most of the time you are looking at the computer, right? So you need to make your eyes strong. So remove your specs, keep it aside. So quickly, I'll show you. If you have time, you do all these eye exercises. Like you have to close your eyes. First exercise, move your eyeballs up and down, up and down, up and down. Just each practice 5 times, up and down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Close your eyes. Now, open your eyes, move your eyeballs side to side, right, left, 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 right, left. Again, close your eyes. Again, open your eyes. Now you have to do diagonal. Look up, right, down, left, up, down. Only eyeballs, diagonal, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Close your eyes. Again, open your eyes, left up, right down, 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 left up, down, up, down, up, down. Close your eyes. Now, last movement for the eyeballs. Open your eyes, look up very slow, right, down, left, up, 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 right, down, left. Close your eyes. Last one. You have to do reverse. Up, left, down, right. Up, left, down, right, up, left, down, right, up, left, down, right, up, left, down, right, up, left, down, right. Close your eyes. Now open your eyes. Listen, if you don't have time to do this eye rotation and all, you can do one practice. This is called palming. What you have to do, let me show you first. When I'm teaching, when I'm demonstrating, you don't do. Okay, first watch. Rub your palms. Rub your palms like this. Okay, you have to create heat by rubbing your palms. When you don't have time to do all those eye exercises, simply do like this. Rub, cup your palms, close your eyes. This portion, middle of this palm, gently touching all the fingers on the forehead, like this. Hold 15 to 20 seconds. Try this now. Rub your palms, all of you. Just rub a bit hard. Remove your specs. This is called palming. Rub, rub, rub a bit hard. You create heat Your eyes should feel that warm. Now place your palms and stay there. 15 seconds. Stay. You place your elbows on the desk. Don't press your eyes. Gentle touch. Stay, stay. It's a nice, relaxing practice for the eyes. Whenever you feel your eyes are tired, do this palming practice. One more time. One more time. Nicely rub a bit hard. Rub your palms. Rub your palms. Always look straight and do this palming practice. Place your elbows on the desk. Gentle touch. No pressure. Hold. Hold. Your eyes should feel that warm, that heat. Wait. Wait. Give some time. Drop your hands down. How do you feel now? How the eyes are feeling? Relaxed?
Very relaxed.
Huh?
Very relaxed.
Very relaxed, right? So we finished with the neck, we finished with eyes. I taught you all the eye rotation. If you have time, you do that. Otherwise, just simply do the palming practice. That's enough for the eyes. So come to the neck and shoulders. Suppose if you have neck, shoulder issues, simple practice. Sitting in the chair, take your hands over your head, lock your fingers, just lock your fingers, lock them, lock them, lock. Then stretch your palms up to the ceiling. Hold for 30 seconds and see how it works. Asana means holding, no movement. Okay, so comfortably for some time. Hold, elbows straight, close your eyes. Kalyani, switch off the microphone. I'm hearing my own voice. It disturbs them. Hold. 30 seconds to hold. Keep your elbows straight. Wait, wait. To do yoga, what you require is little patience, okay? Then it works wonders. Believe me, you know, you can achieve all your goals by spending time with yourself. Hold, hold. See how it works. Asana means holding. So when you stretch and come out, what happens? That area will improve oxygen and circulation. Exhale down. Clear? So like this, you have to repeat 2-3 times, holding 15 to 30 seconds. One more time. Stretch your hands up. Stretch. Every part we are going to work now. Stretch. Hold. After this, I'll teach you how to meditate. Stretch. First, you need to tense your body. Then only it will help you to relax. So what you have to do, you have to observe where all is the stiffness. It shows when you are holding, where is the weakest part? Okay, where is the tension? Where is the stiffness? It shows very clearly. You'll understand your body better when you are holding the asana. You can feel the pain, right? Yes or no? It's working, right? Hold. Exhale down, drop your hands down. One last time, again. Take your hands over your head, lock your fingers, stretch your palms up. So while you're repeating, for strengthening, holding, repeating, okay, relaxing. You have to learn to relax. That comes, relaxation comes with practice. Initially, you'll find it very difficult to hold because you never stretch your hands like this, right? So if you are doing for the first time, the pain will be more. Your body is showing the stiffness. That's all. Best asana to relax your neck and shoulders. You don't get all these neck and shoulder issues regularly if you practice this. Stretch, stretch, hold. Ocean, come on, hold. Stay in the position. Breathe. So yoga will also increase your willpower, you know. It shows your potential. It's not simply, you know, it's an exercise. You're challenging with your body and mind, holding the posture. So all these things you start working when you're doing day-to-day life also. That's what yoga teaches. Exhale down. Drop your hands down. How is it? How is it? So naturally, your shoulders, neck will improve circulation by doing this.
Yes,
clear?
Sir. Yes.
I have back issues continuously sitting on the laptop and.
So now we are coming to that. So this, we finished till here, right? So this trunk part, how to work, sitting in the chair, you just stretch your hands, okay? You just do the simple twist. I'm showing in my chair. So that whole spine. So what yogis discovered, you know, our health depends on the flexibility of the spine. Okay, there are only 5 movements possible with the spine. So all the asanas, if you see here one chart, based on the spine movement. So sitting in the chair, you just do this spinal movement. So you can prevent from this neck, upper back, middle back, lower back issues. So you sit slightly edge of the chair. Okay, always keep your spine straight. Let me show you first. Then stretch your hands up, stretch. Catch hold of your left knee with your right hand. Place your palm exactly behind your back and use your breathing. Push your tummy inside slowly. Don't give jerk. Take your time. Exhale and twist. So when you're twisting, feel each and every vertebrae you're twisting. Turn the head. You bring both shoulders into one straight line. Clear? If you don't have place here, just hold here. This is also fine. So basically, you're twisting each and every vertebrae once to the right, then stretch, twist. Stretch, twist. Do this now. Now you got some idea how to twist. You have to keep your spine straight, twist your spine to the right side, come up, left side. Come up, twist. Keep doing that at least 10 times. So don't do mechanically. Connect with your spine. Connect with your vertebrae, your skull, and your breathing. When you're twisting, breathe out. When you're stretching your hands, breathe in. Okay, try that. Try that a couple of times. Your back feels very relaxed. Keep doing. Keep doing. In the chair, you can do this. Twist your vertebrae. Keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. Hands up, exhale and twist. 10 rounds, keep doing this. People, you practice this, you can prevent from this lower back issue. Simple practice, but very, very effective. Okay?
Yes, ma'am, after doing spine jo hai wo chatak gaya ek baar bhi.
Ek baar chatak gaya.
Haan, pura ka pura wo crack, it just crackled like cut, 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 cut.
Yeah, because you're writing, you're doing for the first time this kind of twist, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So they're just releasing the stiffness, nothing to worry. You're not going to break anything with this simple practice, okay? Just be aware of your breathing, everything, like, you know, first day you feel all these chatak patak sounds, but with regular practice, everything will disappear, okay? Yeah. So this is for the whole spine. Now we are coming to the hip joints. Just keep the ankle on the knee, okay? How to release the stiffness from your hip joint? Place the ankle on the knee. Hug your knee close to the chest. Clear? Hug your knee close to the chest. Use both hands. Then press the knee close to the ground. You slightly bend your spine and press the knee close to the ground. so that you can feel the stiffness in your hip joints. Don't push too hard, okay? You're not breaking here. Gently, gently. You're not crossing your limit and you're not competing with anybody. Everyone's body is different, anatomy is different, and stiffness is also measures. Okay, when you are in 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, the flexibility varies. Okay, so the main difference a 5-year-old and 50-year-old is the flexibility of your spine. Okay, whole yoga is to retain that flexibility so that you can remain as a child. For a 5-year-old, there is no question of stress, there is no BP, no sugar. Why? They're so flexible. They don't know about all these things, stress. So by practicing yoga, you are retaining that flexibility and you are becoming like a child. That's the goal of yoga. How to be happy all the time. That's what yoga teaches, right? So just hug the knee close to the chest, then press the knee close to the ground. Try that a couple of times. Hug your knee, hold your ankle with opposite hand, then press the knee and just hold there and see how it works. How it works. Just place the right palm above the knee and be gentle. Just stay like this. 30 seconds. Hold. So this will release the stiffness from your hip joints. Clear? Yeah. Change. Then do other side. Take the left ankle on the right knee. Hug your left knee close to the chest. Then press the knee down. Knee down. Hug your knee close to the chest. Then press the knee down. Hug your knee close to the chest. 5-6 times. Down. Come up. Down. Come up. Down. Come up. Down. Come up. Down. Right? So next, we are coming to the knees. Just if you don't have any issues with the knees, hug your knee close to the chest like this. If your knees are stiff, better keep your hands under your calves and between your calves and thighs, then hug the knee like this, down. So this will help you to release the stiffness from your knees. Hold 5-10 seconds, then release. Down like this, keep moving. Do this for 2-3 times. Clear? Now come to the ankles. Stretch the leg, rotate your ankle. Clockwise few rounds, reverse few rounds. Drop. Other leg. 5-10 rounds clockwise, then reverse. Okay, now lift both legs up and down. This is also very good practice for the knees. If you want to prevent from knee issues, see, knees and elbows, these are the only movements you can do it with joints, knee joints, elbow joints. Only these movements are possible. You don't rotate the knees like this. They do circles and all. That is not allowed. So these are the only movements possible with your elbows and your knees. Both together you can do. 10 times. Every joint needs some movement. That's all you have to do. Okay. So for the wrist, we didn't do anything because you work with your wrist most of the time, right? You use your mouse for the wrist. So there is a possibility to get this, carpal tunnel syndrome. You get pain here, okay? So to prevent all those things, you just stretch like this. Make a fist with your hands, okay? You're doing with me at least for 30 seconds to take care of your wrist. Stretch your hands, thumb facing to the ceiling. You draw imaginary 8 with the wrist. You move your wrist more. Keep moving. A simple practice to make your wrist strong. Keep moving. Keep moving. 30 seconds, okay? Keep moving. Close your eyes. Connect with your joints, ligaments. Do with awareness. keep moving. Only 30 seconds, I said. Don't drop your hands down. Challenge with your body and mind. Come on, don't give up. Keep moving. So watch your breathing. That helps to continue. Keep moving. I said 30 seconds. Do it. Don't give up. Come on, Ocean, Kujur. Keep doing. Radhika, very good. Continue. Last 10 seconds. Now just stretch your fingers. Hold for another 15 seconds. That's all. Breathe. It shows the stiffness behind the neck, shoulders, elbows, upper arms. Just observe where all is the stiffness. Understand your body better. Breathe. The more you focus on your breathing, it helps you to reduce the aches and pains. Breathe. Last 10 seconds. Om 1. Om 2. Om 3. Don't give up. Om 4. Breathe. Om 5. Om 6. Elbow straight. Simple practice to work with your neck, shoulder, wrist. Om 7. Om 8, Om 9, Om 10. Exhale down. How is it?
Too much.
You're speechless?
Little bit paining.
Lots of pain and like...
Yeah, you're...
You're making us realize how stiffed and cranked up we are right now.
Yes.
Yeah. You're all speechless, right?
Yeah. After the yoga. While the moment every joint was like crack, cut, yeah. cut.
Yes. So we finished from toes to head. Did you realize that? So before the session, after the session, now tell me how you feel now.
Energized,
right? So one breathing practice we'll do, simple practice to feel more energetic. Simple practice. Everybody can do this. Okay. Like this. One. When I say one, you have to inhale. Two, exhale. Let me show you first. One. One, inhale. Two, exhale. Okay. We'll do 30 pumpings. Each breath will count as one, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. I'll give you the instruction. You're moving your shoulders, hands, elbows straight up and down. Clear? Yeah. Close your eyes. You have to listen to my instruction. That's all you have to do. Yeah. Back straight, hands up. One, inhale, two, out breath. One, two, 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 one, two. Relax. Close your eyes. Relax. Just observe how the body is feeling. Close your eyes, observe your body. Yoga, it's not a religion, remember. Just you're working with your body, mind, and your energies, and with your breath. Just observe your body. We'll try to do one more round. So 30 pumpings. Come on, hands over your head. One, two, one, two, 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 1 2 How is it? Are you feeling energetic or not?
Heartbeat is going faster.
Going faster? Relax. It makes you more alert, you know. Every cell of your brain, it works. Simple practice. Relax.
It's like a bumpy feeling in your head.
Yeah. It activates every cell of your brain. Yeah. Relax. Deep breathing. So I'll teach you simple pranayama. This is called Ujjayi. Listen, let me show you. So you open your mouth like this. Make that ha sound, okay? With inhale, ha sound. With exhale, ha sound. Got it? This is the technique. Do like this 5-6 rounds. Open your mouth and do this. Back straight. Come on. Close your eyes. Inhale. Close your eyes. Open your mouth. Ha sound. Inhale. Again. Exhale. Open your mouth. Wide open. Five, six times. Repeat this. Prolong your breathing. That's all you have to do. One minute. You got the technique? Listen. You got the technique, right? Can you produce the sound? Ha with inhalation. Again, ha exhalation, right? Now close your mouth. Do the same thing. That ha sound, you have to breathe through the nose. Clear? It's a very simple pranayama. According to your lung capacity, prolong your breathing. Okay? The more you prolong your breathing, that makes your mind more calm, more quiet. Okay, keep your spine straight. At least 10 breaths. Count every inhalation as one. Produce that sound. What you did by opening your mouth, close your mouth and do. Close your eyes. So your breathing is more deep. It will touch your throat. This is called Ujjayi, victorious breath. Close your mouth, 10 deep breaths. Practice that. Yoga is 99% your practice. Theory is only 1%. Theory doesn't work here. An ounce of practice is better than tons of theory. So learn this simple breathing technique. Any difficulty by closing your mouth, you practice more of opening your mouth for a couple of days, then close your mouth and do this. 10 deep breaths. Count every in breath as one. Few minutes, practice this. Close your mouth. Nobody can hear that sound. Only yourself you can hear that sound. That sound. Relax and prolong your breathing. Yoga and meditation, they are not separated. They are together. Meditation is part of that yoga. All this yoga is how to deal with this mind. How to balance your emotions. That's the ultimate goal of yoga. So you have to learn how to regulate your breathing, how to control your breathing. So that will help you to how to control your emotions. So now you're working with your breath, with the simple Ujjayi breath. Practice, practice. 2-3 minutes. So got the technique? Clear? Clear? Can you switch on microphone and answer my question? Is it clear? Ujjayi breath is
yes.
Clear?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes, madam. Yes, yes, ma'am.
No doubt, right?
Yeah.
No so doubt. If you're finding it difficult, initially some
yes,
of you find it difficult to
yes,
breathe.
Ma'am.
So open your mouth and practice for a couple of days. Same thing, you close your mouth and practice. Very simple technique. The name itself is Ujjayi breath, victorious breath. Okay? So, if you want to do meditation, you have to practice this for 5 to 10 minutes. Okay? Then, Vipul.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm coming to your questions. You asked me how to make this mind calm.
Yes,
so,
ma'am.
You have to work with your breath first. This is the first thing you have to do. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Then, the second one will chant Om. Okay? At least 11 times you chant Om. So, when you're chanting Om, it's a combination of A, U, Ma. Three letters combined together forms Om. Okay, it's not a religious thing. It's a sound vibration. Okay, when you're chanting Om, when you say A, it works with your lower portion of the lungs. When you say U, it works with your middle portion of the lungs. When you chant Ma, it works with your upper portion of the lungs. You observe when you're chanting Om, you are using your full lung capacity. In this corona, the part which we have to take care is the lungs.
Yes,
okay?
Ma'am.
So the breathing will teach you how to strengthen your lungs, how to concentration power. Only when you learn how to concentrate, naturally the success will come. Okay? So that is what you are learning. Concentration and strengthening your lungs. Right? So we'll chant Om openly first, then I'll teach you how to close and I'll teach you one more pranayama practice that is called Brahmari. First learn how to chant. Close your eyes. First take a deep inhalation. Let me show you 2-3 times, then you're repeating with me. You switch off the microphone and chant with me so that I can hear. Okay? Yeah. Close your eyes. Take a deep inhalation, observe. So that ma sound, you try to prolong. Okay? Right?
Okay, ma'am.
That's all you have to do. Yeah.
First, inhalation or we jo hum om ka jo pronounce karenge along with that we have to exhale.
Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Now, first inhale with the sound, you have to exhale. You just observe how it starts from the navel and how it ends with your this portion, your mouth. Clear? Yeah. Close your eyes. Always keep your spine straight. 11 rounds will do. Ready? Take a deep inhalation. According to your lung capacity, just chant. Again, inhale. Again, inhale. Inhale. Again, inhale. Again, inhale. Inhale. Again, inhale. Again, inhale. Again, inhale. Again, inhale, last round. Just close your eyes, few seconds, feel the vibration. Mute your microphone, please. Now open your eyes. So now you got clear idea how to chant Om, right? Say yes or no.
Yes, ma'am.
So did you observe? You're using your full lung capacity, right? When you're chanting Om. Did you notice that?
Yes, ma'am. जैसे जब last में M आता है तो यहाँ पे chest के upper portion में vibration feel होता है.
Yeah, actually here it ends with the pit of your throat.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. To make your more mind calm, so now how to do this one more pranayama, brahmari. Before you start your meditation, 5 minutes ujjayi pranayama, 5 minutes brahmari pranayama you have to do. Then that will allow you to sit comfortably for a couple of minutes, okay, without any distraction. So I'll teach you how to do meditation also. First, we are doing the practical session. Then I'll teach you the steps to follow to meditate, okay? So you have to clear the close these earlobes. Take this index finger, this one. You don't put the index finger inside the ear, okay? Close this earlobe with the index finger. Clear? Then, okay, elbows away from your body. Let me show you first. Close your eyes. That ma sound, you have to prolong. In that a, u, ma, that ma sound alone, you have to keep. Okay, yeah, yes. Close your earlobes. Inhale. Fix your mind on the pit of your throat. Again, inhale. Got it? Okay, you're doing with me. I'll give you the instruction. Just 5-6 rounds. Close this. You remove your earplugs, earphones. Close this earlobe. Don't put the index finger inside the ear. This thing, the small one, you have to push it inside the ear. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Back straight. So it gives a nice vibration in the brain. It makes your mind calm. So don't spread your elbows to the sides, slightly down. Okay, now close your earlobes, look straight, fix your mind on the pit of your throat, take a deep inhalation according to your lung capacity. From day one, you are not competing with me. Everybody's lung capacity is different. According to your lung capacity, just prolong, right? Yeah. Inhale, close your eyes, start. Again, inhale. Again, inhale. Again, inhale. Inhale. Again, inhale. Two more. Inhale. Inhale. Now don't open your eyes. Drop your hands down. Keep your spine straight. Close your eyes. Bring all your thoughts between your eyebrows. Just observe your mind. Meditation is not to control your mind. As long as we are breathing, thoughts keep coming. Just watch them. Let your thoughts come and go. Just be witness to your thoughts. Let your thoughts come and go. Doesn't matter whether it is positive or negative. You're not acting in those thoughts. You're not taking any role in those thoughts. Like a movie. Only thing, you don't act in that movie. Ten minutes, we'll practice this. Let your thoughts come and go. Check your spine straight. Look straight. If you want, you can lock your fingers. Place your palms above your thighs. Whole body is completely relaxed. The more you observe your thoughts, more clarity comes to your thinking. Your thinking capacity will increase naturally. When you're taking a decision, be very clear. There is no confusion to say yes or no. Just observe your thoughts. Let them come and go. By watching your thoughts, slowly train this mind to watch the breath. For that, you need any mantra, take Om or anything like which has some divine meaning. Inhale that mantra, exhale. So we are training the mind to watch the breath. After some time, it takes you to go beyond this physical dimension. That doesn't happen in one single day. It takes a couple of months. By watching your breathing, with the mantra, inhale the mantra, exhale. Stick to one mantra. Don't change the mantra every day. Mantra is nothing but a sound vibration. Inhale the mantra. Exhale. Between, mind goes here and there. It's okay. It's the nature of the mind. You cannot force the mind to watch the breath. Slowly, you have to train the mind. 5 more minutes. Observe. Do palming, rub your palms. Cup your palms, gently place your palms on your eyelids. Then drop your hands down. Yeah. So this is a practical session you did. Instead of theory, you first did the practical session. So how to get into meditation. Vipul, how is it?
It was awesome.
Huh?
And it was awesome. And ma'am, I have one query. Jaise when I was, you know, aapne bola ki close aankhe band karke jab focus karna hai ek point pe, so whenever I try to focus, why this portion gets heavy?
Because you are bringing your eyeballs to look at this position. Don't do that. Okay? You just relax. When you bring your eyeballs here and you force yourself to look in between your eyebrows, you will end up with headache.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay? Okay, that's not a thing you are doing. Okay? So, quickly, if you want, you note down the points, how to prepare yourself for meditation. Yes, okay? Ma'am. You guys want to know or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Only you are the only one who is answering out of 82 people. Okay, nobody.
Yes,
I don't
ma'am.
Know.
Yes, ma'am.
You guys want
yes,
to
very
know?
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, Mara ma'am. Prasad. We all are here.
Yeah.
Yes, madam. Yes, madam. Such a wonderful session, ma'am. Thank you for giving this about yoga and
listen, I have not yet finished. I have to give practical thing quickly. Yeah, you have a question or you want me to wind up the class? Varaprasad?
I have a question, madam. When we have to do these yoga and asana, madam, before the exercise and after the exercise?
Yeah, I'm going to give to discuss all those things. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. So just note down how to prepare practically for this meditation. Okay. First thing, in 24 hours, you have to take time for yourself. That is the first thing. And you have to fix your time. Okay. Every day, same time you have to follow. Okay, one day morning, one day evening, one day afternoon, it doesn't work. Every day you have to fix your time. That is the first thing, right? And in your house, if you have a separate room, that's the most luxury. Okay, otherwise, take one corner. Take one corner. Nobody will disturb that place. Like that, you choose one place. Time and place are very, very important. Okay? Choose one place where nobody disturbs you. Okay? That's the first thing. And use one carpet, small carpet. You're not sitting on the floor directly, because when you sit on the floor directly, what happens? Your energy goes into the floor. So always use one mat, duri or something. Okay? Use and sit on that. How do you sit? Comfortable position. Okay. So people who can't sit down, they can adopt sitting on the chair. At least one leg you sit like this. This is also difficult. You sit like this. What we did now, you do the same thing. Otherwise, this is the most comfortable position. Cross leg position. Okay. Adopt a cross leg position. Clear? And you choose your palm position. Either you cross your fingers like this, or if you want to use the mudra, this is called chin mudra, where your tips, thumb and index fingers are touching each other. Chin mudra, you write down, okay, chin mudra, so that if you get any doubt, you can Google chin mudra and place your palms like this. Always keep your spine straight. Listen, you're not taking wall support. What happens if you take wall support? You go to sleep. Don't do that. Okay, it's okay. 5 minutes also, you sit without support. Don't ever do with wall support. Always keep your spine straight. If you sit like this, okay, your energy will get blocked. So purpose of doing meditation is, when your mind is calm, what happens? Extra cosmic energy flows into your body. That helps you to enhance your work. Okay, that's the advantage of doing meditation. Every day, you're recharging this body more and more. Okay, so all the aches and pains will get cleared with regular practice of meditation. All these aches and pains are related to energy body. When there are blocks in the energy body, they appear as aches and pains on the physical level. So when you do meditation, it helps you to reduce those blocks. Clear? And when you sit and watch your thoughts every day, what happens? It brings you more clarity for your thinking. Okay? And you learn how to take life as it comes. The situations won't allow you to react. You listen to the serious, very serious thing. You will know how to deal with those things. You'll be in the peak traffic. You don't keep on buzzing the horn, you know. You get that patience, you know. So you will know whether your meditation is working or not, you check in the peak traffic, how you're reacting. Okay? That's all. You're enlightened. Okay? If you're not reacting in peak traffic, that means your meditation is working. Try that. Okay? You're not reacting to the horn, somebody's horn, doing that sound behind you, next to you. Somebody's crossing you, overtaking. When people are doing all those things, just check how you're reacting. Okay? Even in those situations also, you don't react. You start dealing the situations differently once you start observing your thoughts. Okay? Meditation is not controlling your mind. You have to watch your mind. You have to keep distance from your mind. That is what is meditation. Okay? So preparation is you have to choose the same time, same place. Best time is sun rising. The Brahma Muhurta. Brahma Muhurtam is like 3:45, but we are not getting up at 3:45. If you get up at 3:45, you sleep in the office. Don't do that. Okay? Better try to get up 5:30. That's the ideal time. Okay? Because body also has certain things. Every internal organ works with different timings. So body wants to do that excretion before sunrise. That's the reason why you have to get up. Okay? So that's when body wants to clear all the toxins. So first listen. Try to eat early. Early dinner, light dinner makes so much difference in your breathing and you're in meditation. Clear?
Try to
early dinner, light dinner. Okay, that makes so much difference if you want to practice meditation. Okay, at least 7:38, you finish your dinner. Before going to bed, 3 hours gap should be there. So that by the time you go to bed, the digestion will finish. Clear? So if you are eating non-vegetarian, little more early. You just observe. When you eat non-vegetarian and if you sit for meditation, your mind is more restless. You just observe this. You can't do meditation on those days because your diet and your breathing are completely related. Because I experiment all these things every day. I sit for my meditation every day at 5 o'clock, sometimes, 4:45. Some days my meditation is so restless, then I realize it is all depending on my diet. When I eat chicken biryani, next day my meditation is very, very restless. So when I eat sattvic food, more vegetarian and all, I can see the difference. This is my practical experience, which I'm sharing with you. So same place, same time, clear. So sun rising, sun setting, these are the best timings. If these two timings are not possible, before going to bed, okay, that time also you can actually choose. Before going to bed, you sit for meditation. Then try to sit east facing, so that the direction also matters. That helps to, connect with your brain waves and all, it will help you to focus more. East side. Then wear comfortable clothes. Don't sit with jeans. You cannot, it won't be stretchable. Always wear comfortable clothes. Possible, keep separate clothes for meditation. Okay? Because your clothes also affects your energy. Suppose if you see a mechanical person who works in mechanic shop, how he wears that dirty clothes. When he sits for meditation, all those energies also very, negative energies. So always wear clean clothes. Possible, separate clothes, you keep it. When you're sitting for meditation, keep your body clean. Quickly take a bath, wear these clothes. And so when you use the same mat, same clothes over a period of time, it creates with you your own energy. Don't share your mat with anybody. Like how you do, don't share your toothbrush, right? You're not sharing the yoga mat or your mat, okay? Or those clothes with anybody. Keep it yourself. Clear? Then your diet also matters. then your sitting position, your time, your mantra also you are not supposed to change. Your sitting position also you are not supposed to change. So when you practice all these things regularly, your mind will get tuned to it. When you miss that, your mind will tell you like you missed it, you missed it, you missed it. You'll become so restless. That point you will reach. But it takes time, not overnight these things won't happen. You have to give some time, at least couple of months, 2 to 3 months, you give that time. It really helps you how to deal with the stress, okay? How to take things, okay? You have to break this habit and practice this self-discipline, clear? So these are the practical steps, how to get into this meditation. When you sit for meditation, do that Ujjayi Pranayama, Brahmari Pranayama, okay? Slightly bend your body up and down, okay? Do this neck rotation and all. Those things makes you more alert. So that will help you to keep your spine straight. And start with sitting for 15 minutes. Then you can up to increase your time at least 40-45 minutes. That morning time, okay, mind is also occupied with less thoughts. Immediately, it takes you to go more deep into the meditation. So meditation is bringing your mind, your breath, your mind, your breath, and your thoughts together. All three together. Mind, your breath, your... What else? Mind, breath.
Concentration.
Your mind.
Body.
Your breath.
Soul, body, mind.
Thoughts.
Yes. All three together. That one pointedness is meditation. When you reach that stage, it takes you beyond this physical dimension. Then there is no question of fear of death. You will understand what is this life. That's why yogis did all these things. But practically to lead a normal life, it really helps you to deal a stress-free life, okay? You don't come across this stress, anxiety, BP, all those things actually you can prevent. Clear? So this session, practical and theory session. Yeah. Now if you have any questions, let me know. Yeah. Now you can ask me. Mm.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah, good morning. Tell me your name.
My name is Mohammed Rafi.
Yeah, tell me, Mohammed.
Yeah, मैंने past में assistant manager जब job कर रहा था, ma'am. मैंने early morning सब employees को briefing देने से पहले मैंने उन लोगों को brisk walk कराता था, ma'am.
Okay.
So
yeah,
उससे उन लोगों का
yeah that is also good so, because
मैं अभी असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जॉब कर रहा हूँ मैम तो हम सब यहाँ पे ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल बिहेवियर पे काम कर रहे हैं तो जब एम्प्लॉइज को ब्रीफिंग देना बहुत बड़ी उनपे असर करता है तो हमारा मेरा मानना ये है कि ब्रीफिंग में योगा को हम लोग क्यों इंट्रोड्यूस ना करें क्योंकि योगा को अगर 5-10 मिनट के लिए ब्रीफिंग में हम लोग अगर इंट्रोड्यूस करें उससे बहुत सारे फायदे हो सकते हैं ये मेरा ओपिनियन है मैम
या डेफिनेटली एक्चुअली एवरी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिफोर यू नो स्टार्ट देयर वर्क दे शुड मेक अ स्ट्रिक्ट रूल दैट दे शुड डू लिटिल बिट ब्रीथिंग एटलीस्ट दिस थिंग यू नो हैंड्स अप एंड डाउन इट मेक्स मोर एनर्जेटिक नेक एक्सरसाइज ऑल दोस थिंग्स एक्चुअली यू कैन मेक पार्ट ऑफ इट या गुड सजेशन थैंक
यू वेरी मच मैम
थैंक यू Yeah, any questions? Yeah, we'll wind up the class with Shanti Mantra. Close your eyes. Shanti, Shanti. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Indeed, it was a very good experience. And I'm sure
all the participants will agree that we had a wonderful experience doing all the breathing exercises and all that.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. My best wishes to you to progress in meditation.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Let's have a break for 5 minutes, and after that, session 2 will be starting.